Hi, my name is Kim, and I'm a freshman at the Honors College, and last semester I took Honors 110, and I did my research project on the economic impacts of Germany during the 1920s. So my research question was, to what extent did the economic provisions of the Treaty of Versailles and economic weaknesses of the Dawes-Young Plan impact Germany's capability and unwillingness to pay the reparations? So that question looks at two perspectives that I encountered when researching this topic and looking at background information. So the first part of the research question looks into how there was this unrealistic expectation to have Germany pay these reparations to the Allied powers when these provisions from the Treaty of Versailles had been imposed on them as well, and restricted them and made them economically devastated. And one figure who sort of supports that and reiterates that is economist John Maynard Keynes, where he talks about how it was unrealistic and sort of sympathizing and favoring Germany. Whereas the other perspective looks at how Germany was, quote, unwilling to pay these reparations and were capable of paying it, but that is only when the evidence is based on the Dawes-Young Plan, which was American economic aid given to Germany to help them stabilize and gradually pay these loans back to the Allied powers and to help them. Due to Europe's economic state post-World War I. And the researchers look into that and say how, based on these statistics, Germany was capable of paying, but they weren't doing what they could, the most that they could. And with that, what I had found is that it was interesting to look at how these two perspectives arise based on the evidence that they were looking at, and also the type of research too, where the second perspective sort of criticizes John Maynard Keynes' views and sort of looks into how uses his words against him. And that was interesting as well to see how both perspectives had something in common but different interpretations. And one thing that was interesting to also look at is how the American economic aid given to Germany was very temporary, and it didn't have a long-term goal or plan or anything that would be effective to that. And that would show when the stock market crash happened in the US, and how the US had to seize all aid given to Germany because of their economic devastation that they were experiencing. And then that would leave Germany completely vulnerable and devastated economically back to their depression. And ultimately, that would be a factor that would lead into World War II, because one of the sources had also mentioned that it led to the rise of Nazis and the popularity with that, and just left Germany in this vulnerable state. And that was also interesting to look at. So with this research, I found that it was interesting to see how evidence can be interpreted and how researchers interact with one another, where at times they could cite one another, whether it is to support their views or criticize that in favor to support their views. So that was interesting, and also just exploring a topic that I found interesting and looking more into that and how research is being done and continues to be done, even if it's something from a while ago, and see how research keeps evolving and these interactions as well.